gonna get nobody else.
Come on.
But see, he loved me though. King Boy loved me.
Break it down.
Riri loved me. She loved me.
Come on,
I can't leave her like that.
You better say that.
Folks scared to leave this season to enter a new season.
We had a baby together.
Yeah, what? You can't have both seasons. You can't hold on to the old and the new. You better let this go so you can grab that.
Yeah.
And guess what? You can't even take this over here to make sure. Come on. Y'all, make sure. I can't take this until I grab it. Now I got to let this go.
Yeah.
Fumble in the hallway until the door opened up. So people can't get to their level because they're scared to let go.
Amen.
Okay, prop. You prop sign a new house, but I can't let this house right here go. This is my comfort zone. But guess what? Stay right there then. Because see, the gospel ain't about comfort. It ain't no comfort zone. Either you believe God, either you know what God said, and you're going to stand on it all the way to the end.
That's right.
Come on, Job 3:27. And let me tell you something. Faith don't always feel good.
You better say that.
I ain't trying to act like faith is just an easy cakewalk.
You better say that.
Faith is not always playing it safe. Did you catch that, Walisha? Faith is not always playing it safe. See, if I'm playing it safe, then I ain't in faith. Did you catch that? If I'm playing it safe, that ain't real faith. I got to get out of the safety zone. Did you catch this, Dr. Shum? I got to get all the way out of the zone. Like, okay, God, I'm in the 1,000 feet now. I'm out here.
So
see,
you have to keep your eyes on.
And guess when God show up?
Yeah.
See, but if you're trying to play it safe, if you got 2, 3, you got a plan A, B, and a C, you ain't in faith. The only plan is plan A, the Almighty. That's the only plan, amen?
For the thing which I greatly feared is come upon me, and that which I was afraid of is come unto me.
So the more you focus on your fear, the more it'll manifest. So I ask you, what you looking at? What you focusing on?
That's good.
What are you focusing on?
That's good.
You know, I don't know what you believe in God for, but you need to have some magazines. You need to have some pictures. You need to have something before you that you can plant in your mental space. Did you catch that? So if you focus on your pain, you focus on what you don't have. I ain't got no new furniture. I ain't got no boyfriend. I ain't got no job. If you keep focusing on that stuff, that's what you're going to get.
Amen.
But if you focus on the word, come on now. You get you one scripture out there back. Let's say if you believe in God for a house. Okay, find you a scripture that's got something to do with the house. Deuteronomy 6:10. For I'm going to give you great and goodly cities which you build not. Houses filled full of good things which you fill not. Wells dig which you dig not. Oh my God, y'all missed a good place to shout right there. He said, I'm going to give you everything that you ain't had nothing to do with if you just believe it.
Amen.
So he said, I'm going to give you houses filled full of good things which you finished now. That means the beans is in the garage, Jack.
Amen.
Why? Because the house filled full of good things which I finished not.
Right.
That's for transportation, boats, trains, and planes. All that is in the house.
Amen.
Did you catch that?
Yes.
So what you focusing on?
What are you focusing on?
See. And sometimes you can focus on something. So, see, in Job's case, he focused on that thing so hard until it manifested death. It took his kids and his money. The thing that I focus on the most, it can lead to death. Well, if it can lead to death, what's the flip side? It can lead to life. You got to change your focus. You never got your mama out till you change your focus. See? Let's go to Numbers.
This is good.
Numbers, because see, check this out. Fear will lead and produce other voices beside God.
You better say that.
Okay? Fear has a voice. And it's going to come straight against the voice of God. So if God tell you to do something, guess what that fear will be like? Nah, see, that ain't going to happen. But you know, he's going to do it. A whole nother door of stuff to deal with, to overcome.
All right, all right.
Okay. Glory to God. Let's go to Numbers 13. I'm telling you now, this season right here, hey, I'm just waiting on you to call. I'm just waiting on you to call. God just offered me a job with I don't even know what to do. They talking about moving to California. I don't even know nobody in California. Okay, well, what you gonna do? You gonna stay here with everybody you know and stay broke? Or you gonna move with your people you don't know and go and get a bankroll?
You gotta say that. Come on now.
Because if God brought you to it, he'll bring you through.
Yeah.
You think I'm going to give you an opportunity to not be there with you?
Yes.
Not be there for you?
Yes.
Guess what? It's already worked out. The fact that I brought it to you, I already worked it out. I just need you to come in. See, the kingdom is about boldness. See, if you feel like you're not qualified, okay, come boldly to the throne then. Throne of what? The throne of grace. What did I just tell you? I told you, grace is how you're going to operate in a place that you're not qualified to operate. How are you going to do it?
It's good.
Through the grace.
Grace.
We come boldly to the throne of grace.
Amen.
Why? Because I'm not qualified for this thing that you just offered to me, God.
That's it.
So I'm going to the throne so I won't mess it up. Lord, I need some mercy.
Uh-huh.
I need some grace on this thing and this help for this time of need.
Yeah.
I need some grace. God, King Solomon sold 1,000 burnt offerings. God came to him in a dream. Okay, what you want? Well, you know, hey, I just need some wisdom to treat your people right.
Amen.
Okay, well, since you didn't ask for a long life, since you didn't ask for all the money in the world, I'm going to give you all the money, I'm going to give you all the wisdom, I'm going to give you all the power in the land simply because you was concerned about wisdom and treating the people right.
Amen. My God.
See, that's my prayer. That's my prayer. Lord, let us treat the people right.
Yeah.
I know people got issues and I know the devil will twist stuff on folk, but Lord, let us treat the people right.
Amen.
You feel me? Let us, even when they think it's an attack on them, let us pray them all the way through.
Yeah.
We're not rejecting, we're accepting. We receive. You hear? This teaching ain't twisted. You feel? Ain't nobody getting offended. We getting free.
Come on, man.
See? Come on, Numbers 13. Well, I said Numbers 13, 30 and 32.
30 and 32?
Yeah. So, God, sometimes God going to send you to go check something out just to see what you going to say.
Come on, man.
Did you catch that?
Yeah.
Sometimes he going to send you somewhere just to see how you going to respond.
Come on now.
See, you might not never say nothing back to God, but he going to read your heart while you checking out the thing he told you you're going to check out. I mean, Proverbs said, go to the car lot. Go to the car lot. Go take your spirit through some of these houses.
Mm-hmm.
Ain't that what I say?
Yeah.
Why? Because you got to go spy out the lane.
Yeah.
You got to go, okay. See, I'm just a 400 a month. See, this is like 2,400 a month. Let me see how this time here feel. Woo, boy, I can just get used to this. But see, God waiting in and said, Lord, I receive.
Yeah.
That's what he waiting on. God, if you told me go check it out, hey man, I receive. Forget it. I receive. It's better than where I'm at. I receive. It's better than what I got. I receive. It's better than what I was even expecting. I receive.
See?
See? Come on.
Mm-hmm.
Caleb. Verse 3.
And Caleb stilled the people before Moses.
Uh-huh.
And said, let us go up at once and possess it, for we are well able to overcome it.
Keep going.
31. But the men that went up with him said, we be not able to go up against the people.
Scared.
For they are stronger than we.
Don't you know you can't pay for it? You knew that before you went over there. Did you catch it? I knew I couldn't pay for it before I went over there. But God sent me over there. So God sent me over there. Guess what? It's already paid for.
Yeah.
I said it's already paid for.
Yes, sir.
He sent them to go spy the land out. They went over there like, hey, man. They went over there. That folk is tough going over there. Well, they over there, they come back talking about they grasshoppers. We be grasshoppers. They giants over there. We grasshoppers. Okay, so, hey, guess what? If you're a grasshopper, you need to hop on away from him. Because you ain't going to get nothing.
That's right.
In this seat, you got to be a giant, not a grasshopper.
Yeah.
You got to be a giant, not a grasshopper.
All right.
Fear is what's got you in grasshopper status right now. Fear is why ain't nobody want to look at no new house right now. See, I'm this one. You win this one? Okay.
Thank you, Jesus.
See, money. See, one is wondering about getting a new house. This one? Oh. Okay. Sean? Okay.
Yes.
We got a fruit giants in here. Any more grasshoppers? Okay, we want friends to shop it. Okay. Anybody? Who next?
Hey.
My Mercedes.
And my Porsche coming.
Okay.
Wow.
Okay. I just want to make sure I was in the right people. Okay.
We went to Porsche.
Okay. Because I really hate to pull up on y'all. Y'all still believing. Y'all still believing. It ain't came past yet.
With the truck
and mouth.
See, you got to get your mouth.
That's right.
That's what we were talking about this morning, 5 a.m. prayer. Yeah. Isaiah said, I am a man of unclean lips. I dwell amongst people with unclean lips. Yeah. In other words, you're not speaking faith.
Yeah.
But see, the more you speak, oh my God.
Uh-huh.
Goodness,
the more you speak in faith.
Speaking faith. Mm-hmm. See, when you speak in faith, glory to God, that means I believe it's possible for me to have.
All right.
Did you catch that? Mm-hmm. You either speak in faith or you either speak in fear.
All right.
If you believe it, though, see, if you speak in fear, your words going to reflect it. Just like if you speak in faith, your words going to reflect. Because, see, faith without works is dead.
Right.
So if you speak in faith while you talking, you're going to start moving.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Did you catch that?
Mm-hmm.
So if you wouldn't look through the house now, this is what I feel in my spirit. I feel y'all wouldn't look. Yeah. But y'all was a little scared. Go back.
Keep looking.
I need y'all to go back.
Keep looking.
And act like you got it.
You said you got to override the fear.
See, that's the difference. You got to act, not just look, act like you got it.
That's right.
It's me.
We went looking at a $5 billion house.
Mm-hmm.
And you know, they ain't even playing with you about no $5 million property. All that time you come spectating and all that, they want to see bank statements, you hear what I'm saying? They want to make sure you got it before we even take our time to let you walk through our house.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? Man, we rolled up on them folk. Man, I wish y'all could have seen us. I'm talking about rolled up on them. Like, hey, it's already in the bank. He said, your bank statements. And listen, man, my daddy owned all the cows on 1,000 Hills, man. Do you want to sell this house? Hey, I had got the dude down to some deals that he hadn't even planned. When I got to talking to dude said, if you get this house, I'm going to throw this $50,000 table in right here. He said, I'm going to let y'all have all these drapes right here. He said, these drapes cost $100,000. He said, I'm going to throw off. When I got to talking to dude, hey, the dude called me for about 3 weeks. He, okay, Mr. Gillespie, everything? You got to act like you got it.
Come on, now.
Act like you got it.
Come on, now.
Don't go in there scared. Why? Because they're going to detect that you're scared.
Come on, now.
See, whenever you come to the table, it will be detected.
Yes.
See, you come to the table with rejection, guess what? So rejection gonna manifest. So if you come to the table with faith,
what'll help you to not be in fear is if you go to Genesis, where we started out with.
Right.
First of all, we were made in his image.
Right.
And see, certain things you have to know to operate from faith.
Right.
You can't just not know, skip over that part, then try to be in faith.
Right.
You got to understand that I was made in the image of God. We can't go past that. That's in Genesis. That's Genesis 1. He's a creator. I was made in his image. And then he gave me what? Dominion. Then he blessed me. Then he told me to go be fruitful and subdue the earth.
My God.
So therefore, he was up there in heaven, running heaven. Who did he send down here to be subduing the earth? We are. See, we're looking for, a supernatural being to fall from the sky. And then we just start falling. That's not how it's going to operate. He sent you here. He sent man here to govern the earth. So right. You got to understand, I was made in his image. He gave me dominion. And then he blessed me. I got the power, the authority to subdue the earth.
Right.
I have no fear. And he gave me power over the fish, the fowl of the air, every creeping thing, every living thing. So I ain't got nothing to hold me back. Once I get that understanding, then I can go and face things in a different manner.
Right. And see what God is doing. What God is doing is challenging everyone to come to the next level of their faith.
Amen.
I'm challenging you to come higher. I'm challenging you to do more. Why? So you can receive more. See, at the end of the day, I'm not going to override. I don't care how much you cry. I don't care how nice you is. At the end of the day, I'm not going to override the law of faith to bless you.
Yes. Oh my God.
I'm not going to do that.
Yeah.
You have died. The Bible said these died in faith.
They died in faith.
You have died. Never get your stuff until you get up and add some work. Faith without works. It's dead. Simple as that. And the rappers, they slipping up on prosperity. I'm talking about they don't go to church. But they believe, man, look, man, I'm the coldest rapper on earth.
They operate from one principle.
And they
all those things that be not as though they were.
Come on now.
And they are experiencing a blessed lifestyle from just that one
from what they saying.
One principle.
What they saying. Come on, 2 Corinthians 10 and 5. See. So you got to deal with that fear. 2 Corinthians 10. Verse 5. Here one there. It says, casting down imaginations and every high thing that exalt itself against the knowledge of God and bringing into captivity every thought to the obedience of Christ.
Okay.
So you got to cast down them thoughts. When the devil, when you get ready to move out, I told him that faith and fear is in the same place.
All right.
So when you get ready to move out, the devil going to tell you, no, you can't do that. No, you ain't worthy. No, you know last night what you were doing last night. You feel it? Because condemnation, he's trying to condemn you because condemnation is the enemy to grace. See, grace going to let me get the thing even though what I did last night happened.
Yeah.
Did you catch it?
Yeah.
But if I'm in condemnation, I ain't going to even move. And guess what? I'll still be trapped in what happened when? Last night. It's fear.
Yes.
Some people, don't you know, some people would rather stay in sin. In fear, it's really fear that they in.
Yeah.
But it's back to the outlet. You got to have everything has an outlet.
Mm-hmm.
So if I'm scared, I'm gonna act out this way, which may be sin.
Mm-hmm.
Just like if I'm in faith, I'm gonna act out and add some works to my faith.
All right.
So either way, I'm gonna act out either this way or that way.
Mm-hmm.
But at the end of the day, if it's fear, it's gonna hinder. Because see, back what the text said, to the obedience of Christ. You got to obey in faith.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. See. Then you got that whole thing about superstition. Don't split the pole. What you scared of?
Just get all of the fearful tactics down.
Yeah, you got all that down there.
Just write a whole Bible of fear. Get your own Bible or stuff.
Don't touch my feet with that broom. I ain't going to jail.
The black cat just bust the cop. It's just craziness.
Fear.
What's the last thing you said? My God shall supply all of my needs according to his riches and glory. So you got more knowledge.
It's insane, you know. We growing in our faith. Somebody say, I'm growing in my faith.
I'm growing in my faith.
Yeah, man, I'm growing. I'm getting mentally prepared for this time. You know what I'm saying? I'm getting prepared for the husband. I'm growing in my faith. I'm keeping myself. I'm reading my word. I'm praying. I'm fasting. I'm growing in this thing. 2 Chronicles 20.